Hey guys, it's Sue again. Welcome back to my YouTube channel. So today we are doing a speed build lighthouse home. So I woke up literally in the middle of the night and decided that I wanted to make a lighthouse home. I didn't get up and do it then, although I wanted to, but I had to work the next day. But I thought about it all day while I was at work, and instead of working, well, I did a little of both, I watched other lighthouse build tutorials and speed builds. I looked up lighthouses on the internet, Google Images, and then I came up with an idea in my head. And for some reason, I had this lot in mind when I wanted to build my lighthouse build. I didn't realize how small it was until I got there and how big the lighthouse was, and I still had to build a house on this. So I do actually end up switching to another lot. The other thing too is I always build with small wall heights, and I had to build with a large wall height this time so that the lighthouse looked correct, or I guess, is that the word I'm looking for? Looked accurate. So I did have to build with a tall wall height, which is different for me, but I really liked how the house came together. So what I was going for here is I wanted it to be like a lighthouse that was functioning at one time, and the people who lived in this house were people who ran the lighthouse, and now a family has taken it over and the lighthouse is no longer in service and they remodeled it so it's more like a family home. And I feel like I did accomplish that. So part of the reason why I thought about this is because there was actually a lighthouse for sale in northern Minnesota near Lake Superior that was going for not even that much money, and you could read do it into a house. Like, that was allowed. They made the permit allowable for that. And my dad was saying how he wished so bad that he could buy it because he has a dream of living in a lighthouse, which I never knew before until this. So I said, you know what? Let's build a lighthouse home. And of course, you can find anything on the internet. I'm like thinking I have some sort of an original idea, but if you go on YouTube, you can see that no, it's not an original idea. Plenty of people have done it, and they've done really, really well with it. So I didn't really know exactly what I was going to do. I was playing around with it a lot, but I think it came out pretty good. So the other thing here is I actually recorded a voiceover for this already, and I don't know. I started watching some people's speed builds of recently, nothing to do with lighthouses, but just watching speed builds that are put out there, and people are talking about the 20th anniversary of The Sims, and I know it is a little bit late, but I was actually on vacation when it actually happened. I kind of missed out on the whole hot tub controversy. I didn't know about it till I got home and was catching up on everything on social media. So I found out about the hot tub controversy. I don't know. I guess it's just a thing the Sims community does, which I don't really want to get involved. But okay, so I get it. Like, they should have done something bigger. I actually thought they were. I thought that they were gonna maybe like release some stuff from like the original Sims, like maybe that bed or something. I mean, I'm happy with the hot tub. It's all right. I mean, they give us a lot of free stuff and patches. But anyway, moving on from that, the point I was making is people were talking about their 20th anniversary and like how they've played The Sims for the last 20 years. I have also done the same. So I have actually regularly played all The Sims except The Sims 3, only because my computer could not handle The Sims 3, and so I went back to The Sims 2. And I actually played The Sims 2 up until only a couple years ago. I just could not get into The Sims 4. I just had that base game when it came out, and it just lacked so much to the gameplay, so much depth, that I went back to The Sims 2. I ignored The Sims 4 for years and years and years and years, and somehow I came across some YouTube videos on gameplay, like Let's Plays, different speed builds, and I was like, wow, The Sims 4 has really gotten a lot better since I remember. So what did I do? I loaded up my computer, put in The Sims 4, downloaded some more expansion packs. I have them all now, but at the time I didn't. And it is so much better. Unpopular opinion, but I think Sims 4 is my favorite Sims game. Granted, I can't really say much about The Sims 3 because I didn't play much of The Sims 3 because, like I said, my computer could not handle The Sims 3, so I never really actually played it, and I wasn't about to buy like some high-end camera just so I could walk around an open world. I'm not a big fan of the open world. I don't know. I know a lot of people want that back, but I actually kind of like the way The Sims does it. Yeah, loading screens are a pain, but I kind of like how you still can explore a little bit around you. And yeah, if you walk away too far, you'll have to have a loading screen. It's just not that big of a deal to me. But anyway, so back to the 20th anniversary. So I have been playing The Sims. So I'm a lot older than I think a lot of the Sims 4 community. I'm actually in a YouTubers, Sims 4 YouTubers group, and Somebody asked one day how old everybody was, and one of the people, well, most people were about 19 to 25, I would say. And one person in the group was like, "Wow, I'm an old man. I'm 30." And I said, "Oh, well, I'm 36. So I am by far the oldest one in that group." And I know a lot of the popular Sims YouTubers out there are also probably in their 20s, maybe 30, but I am 36. And I've been playing this since I was 16 years old in the year 2000. And I actually did not play video games at all. I was a console player. I loved anything Nintendo, anything Sega. I was all about it. Mario, all that stuff. Mario Kart, loved it. Actually, we went through a phase where we played GoldenEye a lot, but not the actual game, just when you run around and shoot people. That was a fun game. So I never really was a PC gamer. My dad was, however, and so I don't know. I always grew up with PC games and whatnot, but I just never played them. Well, my boyfriend at the time was very much into PC games, and he became obsessed with The Sims. So much that he was ignoring me, but then one day he said, "You would love this game." So we were in this class. I have to tell you about this class. It was a real class that I had in high school. It was called Build Your Own Class, and all we did was play video games the entire time. I'm not kidding, that was a real class. In fact, his mom got mad at him for taking the class because he was super smart and was gonna go to like a big college or whatever, and she was like mad that he took this class. But the class was really fun, and the game that I always played was Sim City, and he noticed that, and he's like, "Oh my gosh, you have to play The Sims. It's so much better than Sim City." He's like, "You like control the people and stuff." And I was like, "Ah, I don't know, I don't know." Well, one day we were at his house and he loaded the game up and started playing it, and I was hooked. I haven't even touched the computer yet, and I was hooked. I was just looking at him playing, and I'm like, "I have to have this game." So I ended up buying it, but I didn't really have a gaming computer, so I always had to play it at my dad's house. My parents were divorced, so he had his house, my mom had her house. I mainly lived at my mom's, but I would go to my dad's house and sit on the computer for hours on end, where he'd be like, "You need to leave." And I would think about it and dream about it, and it was just an obsession. I was avoiding people, I was avoiding, friends, family, because all I wanted to do was play The Sims. And it's so funny thinking back, because the original Sims was so boring. There was really nothing to the game. They didn't age. I don't know. It was a boring game when you think back. But at the time, it was like revolutionary, and I was obsessed with it. So one thing that I always did with The Sims 1, and I've seen a couple of memes that said this, but I only did it with The Sims 1, is I would play for like 3 months straight, obsessively play, and then I would just instantly stop playing, and then I would not play for months, and then I'd be like, "Oh, I'm gonna load up The Sims again," and I would always start over. So I don't know what the deal was with that, but then I would start over, I'd delete my game, start completely over again, and that was like the cycle. When The Sims 2 came out, The Sims 1 to The Sims 2 was the biggest jump in gameplay, graphics, everything. The Sims 2, oh my god, you guys, when that came out, I couldn't even believe it. I was the stuff you could do in that game, the gameplay in that game was unbelievable after playing The Sims 1. So again, became obsessed with The Sims 2. So I have to tell you about the demise of my Sims 2 game, where I actually cried and my mom was not happy with me. So back in the day, we used to like leave our computers on all the time, and you'd have like AOL Instant Messenger up, and you would just, it would literally say like you've been online for like 27 days or something like that. And once in a while I'd load up The Sims. Well, that computer was on and I was at work. My house got struck by lightning. Well, my parents' house got struck by lightning. It fried all of our appliances in our house. It was bad. It was really bad. And I came home to find this out. My computer was fried. It was fried. You couldn't even turn it on. It was donezos. And my mom is concerned because it's like, how much money is this going to cost her? And all of our appliances are gone. And I'm sitting here crying because I lost my Sims game. Years and years of generations, didn't back up my game back then. I had to start over. It was devastating. My mom was not happy with me that I was crying over losing a video game when she was out thousands of dollars, and we had no appliances for a while until we could get them all replaced. In fact, we pretty much didn't have a microwave for years after that. So that was that. Well, then The Sims 3 came out, and I was so excited. I was so excited for The Sims 3. So I bought it like the day it came out, like going to Best Buy and waiting in line and bought it. My computer could not run even base game. It was bad. It was so glitchy. So I went back to The Sims 2 and I never played The Sims 3 besides a couple of times and my computer being laggy. So I went back to The Sims 2, which I played up until a couple years ago, like I said, because when I bought The Sims 4 in 2014 or 15, it was the white neighborhoods. Oh my God, you guys, it was bad. And so I went back to The Sims 2 up until a couple years ago. There are parts of The Sims 2 I still love, but The Sims 4 is my absolute favorite, you guys. It's so good. So, anyways, I kind of want to go back to this build before it ends. So, this is a big space for me to furnish, but I think I did a really good job. Not to toot my own horn, but I actually filled in this space really well, which you'll see in the screenshots at the end, even with these tall wall heights. And I want to tell you something else. I was so excited for this build. I don't know if some of you guys are out there, but you put your heart and soul into a build and you are so proud of it. You just want to show like everybody. And some of you probably have Instagrams or whatever, and you probably get so excited about builds. This was one of them. I could not wait to put this on my Instagram. I thought it was gonna get so much love. I put it on Instagram. Yeah, I didn't get much love at all. I honestly think if I would have did more with the landscaping and I took pictures with somebody living in the house in tab mode rather than having the line around it, I think that I probably would have got a little bit more love. But it was so disappointing, you guys. I don't know if that's ever happened to any of you out there. Like other houses that, like, you know, I quickly put together or whatever, and then they'll get like tons of likes, tons of downloads, and then like one like this where I'm like in love with it and I get like five downloads and like nobody says anything. It was a little disappointing. But my dad really liked it because my dad wants to live in a lighthouse, going back to that, and I told him I was gonna move his Sim into here. So he liked it, and I guess that's all that matters. And I had fun building it, so that's good too, I guess. So the other thing about this kitchen, see how it cuts off there on that? So I know that people probably look at that and see that little cutoff on the wall thing, but it looked weird the other way too. That's one thing that I want because now, speaking of The Sims 20th anniversary, and kind of now swinging back around to the fact that apparently The Sims 5 is confirmed, it's in the works. I am lukewarm on it because I don't want to start over again. I know I can keep playing The Sims 4. People love to tell me that, well, you would still play The Sims 4. Yeah, I know, but eventually you have to make the switch. So part of me is like, oh, I'm so emotionally attached to this game and my Sims and everything and my generations that the thought of starting over kind of freaks me out. But it's only in the beginning phases. There's still going to be a couple years left. There's still some expansion packs coming out. So, I mean, I'll still get my time to play, and maybe I'll change my mind later on. But I'm a little bit sad about it. But things that I want in The Sims 5, I want to be able to like put trim on walls, like so that you're not just like abruptly ending tile and starting sheetrock. And then like how this wallpaper or paint I'm using with the white trim at the top. Sorry, my dog is readjusting on my lap right now. I like want to be able to continue the trim like through the kitchen, you know, like just things like that. I want spiral staircases. I want to be able to make curved walls, curved landscaping, and I know you can do it with like different like little hacks and stuff. Like I want to just be able to do it. Like I want it in the game. That's something I want. I want better gallery. I want to be able to take my own gallery photos. I want, you know, we're coming up to screenshots here, and I have too many things to list. So instead, I'm gonna do my little outro here. All right, so if you enjoyed this video, then please give it a thumbs up and subscribe to my channel if you haven't already, and thanks for watching.